Whoa! Hold up there! I'm going to put my singing muscles in the bunkhouse for a spell and do a bit of talkifying.
I heard you singing. You got quite a range.
It's not my range. It's everybody's range. That's the thing about the wide open spaces.
Don't fence me in.
Why?
Because I ain't a fancy guy.
You sure ain't. Now, I won't be spouting no highfalutin' speeches like the Gettysburg Address.
What kind of dress is that? With a burger on it? I may get barbecue sauce on my kerchief.
What?
Kerchief. Kerchief.
God bless you. No, you got it wrong. It's not a dress. It's a dress.
Well, that's what she said.
It's a dress, like where you live.
The bunkhouse?
No, no, no. The Gettysburg Address is like what the president makes.
Oh, mistakes.
You should know. Mistakes is your specialty.
You hungry?
Always. Why?
You want some of my steaks?
No, I'm not talking food for gut. I'm talking food for thought. The speech where Lincoln said about his forefathers.
Well, I didn't have forefathers.
No?
I barely had one.
I believe it. We's getting off the trail now. I just want to tell folks what it's like. The cowboy life. Now, it's been a passel of years since the true cowboy days, and folks have forgot. Plus, the movies got it all wrong. Was it exciting?
No, pretty boring most of the time.
Did we shoot folks all the time?
No.
Was it good, clean living?
Clean? Huh? We hardly ever got washed up.
Right. I'd be hard-pressed to say who smelled more. The cowboy or the cow? Uh-oh. Somebody says they can tell.
Tell by the smell. Right, horsey?
We don't play at being cowboys. We work. And it's no joke. But this here's a joke. Why do you never starve in the desert?
What you do?
I know, but it's a riddle. Try to guess it.
Let's see. 'Cause you starve in your stomach. Not the desert.
No, it's because of all the sandwiches there.
Oh.
Now somebody likes my joke. I'm what you call a cowboy. Tell 'em why, Danny.
Well, it's because you're part cow and part boy.
Right. No, let me correctify that. It's just that I'm a boy what takes care of a cow.
Bull.
No, it's true.
But you don't take care of a cow, do you?
No, a herd.
What?
Heard. Heard.
Don't yell. I heard you. We all heard you.
Now, you're probably wondering why I'm conversifying with my hoss.
I'm talking a lot to my horse with no one around. It's the onlyest sound. My horse is talking to me. Believe it or not, he's talking a lot. Don't you know that horses deserve to have a voice? So they might and light. So says my horse champion, champion of horses' rights. I'm talking a lot to my horse, just talkifying, and I'm not lying.
Ain't that right, champion?
You ain't lying. Just telling a tall tale.
Well, maybe a small tall tale. Yep. Horses deserve to have their say. And that ain't hay. No, not nay. Hey! Oh, you're right. You're right. You do deserve to have a nay. In a way. How'd you like that song, Dan?
Well, I ain't no corny sewer.
Oh, no? Well, you are corny, and you do smell like a sewer.
Well, it takes one to know one, fella.